Hi, this video is to get you started on program 8. So program 8 is going to be a Gauss elimination program, and you need to start with the program that's in the book, and we need to do several things to it. So one of the things is that the way the program in the book is set up is it's using arrays. We want to change that so that we can use vectors. Then we want to go back and make it so that we can use any size matrix with the Gauss elimination. So right now from the book it's set at three equations and three unknowns. So it'd be a 3x4 matrix because you have the fourth column is the constant terms. And then the last thing that we want to do is to develop a class and package these functions into a class so that you have sort of the maximum reusability of your code. And the first thing that we need to do to get started is that this program is specifically looking at resistor values to calculate mesh currents. So we don't want to do that. We want it to just be a generic Gauss elimination program. So let's revise the user input part. So I've just commented that specific part out, and let's see if we can get just that part going. So we've got a two-dimensional array in here as written. So let's just use the array and see if we can get a set of for loops working. To read in the values from the user. So let's do an outer for loop to run through the rows, and then let's use an inner for loop to run through the columns. Remember, with the columns, we're going to have one extra value because we've got the constants in addition to the coefficients. So now we've got that for loop set up. Now let's see if we can use it to read in the values. So let's go outside of the for loop. Let's remind the user that this is a 3x4. We'll go back and change that later as we go. Now inside, let's prompt the user now for that first row. And again, we'll prompt the user that we should have four values. Oops, forgot my close double quotes. Then inside of here, we just need to read a value in. So before it had all these different resistance values and voltage values. We don't really need any of those. We just need a temporary storage so that we can read something in. So I'm just going to call that temp. And then we'll read in from the console window into to temp. Then we'll do our matrix is A. So we'll do matrix I sub J. So that'll give us row I, which will start from 0 and go up to 2, 0, 1, and 2. And then this will give us the J part. So it'll go from 0, 1, 2, up to 3. So we'll set that equal to temp. So let's see if we have any errors in this program. Okay, and it goes through and it solves it. And it gives us the values at the end. So it looks like it's working okay. And then now what we'll need to do is work on that output. And we don't really need it to say mesh currents anymore. We can just use solutions here. So it'll do x, and then it'll print out x1, x2, x3, and it'll print out the solutions. So try doing this and see if you can get this program working again. Test it with a matrix, and you can go online and find some matrix solvers online. And make for sure that it's working. And then once you have it working, then try and go back and change this A to a vector and change the solution to a vector. What I would recommend as you do this is to leave A and solution in there and set up your vector. So we'll do a vector for A and a vector for solution. But let's call these something different. So instead of A, let's call this capital V. Instead of instead of solution, let's call this capital S. That way you can kind of run your code in parallel and keep compiling and running to make for sure that you're not causing any problems. You'll need to add vector, of course, at the top. So let's see if there's any issues with the syntax there. And it looks like it's still working. Now that we've got that working, let's try to now make this work with the vector. So one thing that you'll need to do with the vector is you'll need to push back you'll need to resize the outer number of rows before you try to push anything on. So here what we can do is v.resize and just resize it to 3. This v.resize, this will attack the outer vector, the row vector. And then inside here you've got temp already read in, so try to push back temp. So this would be v. And then we need to give it the row, so this would be row I, then the period, then push back. If you don't have the row number in there, it's going to try to push that value on the row vector, and the row vector is expecting a type vector, and you're going to get a type mismatch between a double and a vector. But with it this way, now you're pushing back onto the column, and the column actually is this internal vector that's a double. So let's see if this works out okay. And it seems to be working. Let's confirm. Yeah, so it pushed those values in okay. Otherwise, we would have gotten an error. You probably will want to add a function up here just to print out your vector at some point. So remember, with your functions, they just need to be somewhere above main. Or you can do a prototype here, and then you could do a function at the end. It looks like it would be really easy to take this program that's already written and just make these changes. It will not be as easy as it looks. So don't get frustrated with this program. There's a lot of little fine points where it's easy to make errors. When you have questions or when you get some errors, if you're chasing the same error for 15 minutes, go to tutoring or send me your program and let's take a look at it. Particularly if you're getting runtime errors where you're going off the end of the vector or something like that, sometimes those can be really hard to track down. But in general, if you're trying to track them down, you know, you're like, no, I'll get it, I don't need to go to tutoring. If you do want to try that, just print out everything everywhere, print out the size of the vector, print out everything that you put on, print out everything that you put out, pushed off the vector. And usually that's the best way to find the errors, just making for sure that what you think went on was the same thing that you can pull back out as output. Anyway, I hope that you enjoyed the video, and thanks for watching.